Hello friends, I welcome you all in my YouTube channel, and as is the motive of this channel about homeopathy rubrics and understanding of remedies. So today I will be discussing a remedy, very frequently used remedy, but very misused remedy. Therapeutically, this remedy has been misused so many times, but the actual understanding of this remedy is lacking. So today's remedy is Berberis vulgaris. So today we will be understanding the mind of Berberis vulgaris. This Berberis vulgaris comes from the family Berberidaceae. The theme of this family is sudden change, and because of this sudden change, the person has to adapt. So the conflict is sudden change and the adaptation to this sudden change is done by this remedy. So here Berberis personality is exposed to intense and rapid changes in life, and he feels harassed by these changes which happens in his life. Now when there is a sudden changeable happenings occurring in the life, so person naturally has to play many roles, and here the life dictates such adaptation because it is the demand of the situation which this remedy has to do. And because of constant adaptation in the life, and he has to play so many roles, so there is a feeling of harassment which comes from constant adaptation. Another aspect running in the remedy is of sexuality. The first ailment, which is very, very important in Berberis, is ailment from sexual abuse. Now, how this Berberis personality is being born? So, I am now going to talk about the development of this personality, how the Berberis vulgaris personality is born. What is the condition which makes Berberis vulgaris personality come into life? Suppose there was a pregnant lady and she was constantly being abused sexually. This abuse could be by husband, who is very demanding, who is physically very demanding, and this physical demand is perceived by that lady as an abuse. So this adaptation which the lady has to do is not under her will. She does not want to do such adaptation. She does not want to face this type of situation. Now, because she does not like this type of physical relationship, she has a feeling that it is not good, and this feeling she transmits genetically to the child, and she starts thinking that this child should not be a female child, because if this is a female child, she has to face all these negative situations, and so I want a boy child. If at all the child born is a female, so this becomes a Berberis vulgaris personality. The reaction of this thought process in the mother is seen in the child as aversion to oneself, disgust for self being a woman. So these are the two very, very important key rubrics of verbalis vulgaris. That as a female child, when her mother had faced certain situation, she has a feeling that I should not have been born a female. I should have rather been born as a male child in the family. Now there is a delusion. Delusion, evening, twilight, aggravation. So how do we interpret this rubric? Now here twilight has got two meanings. Number one, twilight means a way of life which involves illegal or immoral activities. So if a life which has more of immoralistic activities, so that type of life is called as a twilight life. Second interpretation is when something is coming to an end. So when the day is coming to an end, there is a particular time when the sun sets and there is some light in the sky, so that is twilight. So end of something is also called as twilight. So here in Barbaris, out of these two, it is the morality feeling which is more important. So twilight is to be interpreted in that sense. So here Barbaris has a feeling that in society, everywhere there is immorality, and this thing is intolerable to Barbaris personality. Now, intolerable, but what is the reaction? The reaction is the disgust which is felt for own self. Why am I born female? Why am I a female being? So this is the reaction of the Barbaris. So the sense of morality or the sense of immorality which is perceived by Barbaris, the reaction to it, which is very, very important, is the disgust for the own sexuality. So now comes the delusion. Delusion, dirty, sexuality is dirty. So there are 3-4 sub-rubrics. Since delivery, delusion, dirty, sexuality is dirty, menses during, delusion, dirty, sexuality is dirty, mother since being a, delusion, dirty, sexuality is dirty, pregnancy since. So all these delusions, they depict only one thing, that is the disgust towards all feminine things. Because of that previous thought process in the genes which was given by the mother to the child. So because this personality is born with certain perception which was given by the pregnant mother. So now what is that perception here in the delusion? So the genetic delusion of Barbaris vulgaris is delusion, injury, about to receive injury is as a woman. This is a very, very important keynote genetic delusion rubric of Barbaris. Single remedy Barbaris is mentioned. So this rubric is very, very important. Delusion, injury, about to receive injury is as a woman. So this rubric is a genetic rubric which comes from the mother to the child. So the whole perception of the female Barbaris personality revolves around this delusion. Male is different. So in physical aspect also, if you see, so I, in my study, so all this interpretation is what I have studied. So in the female chapter of Barbaris, there is no rubric mentioned which says high sexuality in Barbaris. So Barbaris is always a remedy which has aversion to sexuality, which has low sexuality. There is absolutely no sexual feeling in Barbaris. So aversion to coitus with absent enjoyment is mentioned in Barbaris. Numbness of vagina, orgasm delayed, subinvolution of uterus, vaginismus, and all sorts of rubrics related to aversion to sex, even at the level of mind and at the level of physical body is also mentioned. So it is of no surprise that in Barbarius Vulgaris personality, if the conflict have occurred during the pregnancy of the mother and the Barbarius personality was supposed to be born, so here you will find one or the other female reproductive anomalies. Either the uterus will be having some structural or anatomical defect, or in the vagina, or anything. So you will find certain structural anomalies in Barbarius vulgaris female patient. Functionally, later on you will find that the female will be having a very less desire for physical activity. Now there is another delusion. Delusion enlarged. Persons are twilight at. So what does it means? Delusion enlarged. Persons are twilight at. So again, twilight is related to immorality. So this Barbarius personality is looking at the world, and what is the perception? That all the people, they are inclining more and more towards immorality. So, delusion enlarged persons are. Enlarged means the tendency or inclination towards that particular thing of people is getting more and more. So people are being more and more immoral. That is the perception of Barbarius. Delusion images, phantom sees, evening, twilight at. Delusion images, phantoms sees, evening, twilight at. So Barbarius personalities sees such phantom image of people doing all such things. So who is phantom to Barbarius is people who are involved in immoral activities. So these people, they are phantom to Barbarius. And what he sees? Evening, twilight at. It means eventually all people are going towards immorality. That is what Barbarius concludes in his experience of his life. So the perception of Barbarius is tuned, or it is tuned genetically to perceive in such manner. Lot of fantasies are also there in Barbarius. Delusion fantasies throng upon him. A person having a false perception of immorality like Barbarius everywhere will apply this perception. So this perception will be applied even to his relationship also. So there will be a doubt in the mind of Barbarius. So which is reflected in rubric, delusion mother prostitute is. So everywhere he sees that people are immoral. So even he applies this to his own mother also. And that is why this insecurity is giving Barbarius left-sided renal stone, which we all interpret in different fashion. Whenever a patient is having left-sided stones, we are prescribing Barbarius therapeutically without understanding what is the basic conflict in the mind of Barbarius. When such conflict we find in the patient, single dose of Barbarius vulgaris will definitely give you a magical result. And prescribing against this history will never give you result. So all homeopaths who are therapeutically prescribing Barbarius should understand how and why Barbarius has got this tendency. So this is my understanding how the Barbarius has formed left-sided renal stone. Left-sided means conflict with the mother. So there is insecurity which is going on in his mind for his mother, which is reflected in the kidney as renal calculi. Now delusion prostitute she is, another important rubric in Barbarius. So when a female who is having such perception of immorality in the mind towards this whole world, and she is married to a person later on, and that person naturally will have some normal tendencies for human intimacy. So now, when this female is being exposed, mind you, this female doesn't have any inclination towards physical coition or physical intimacy. Even if the slightest provocation for physical activity by a partner, so here again the perception will be, why is my partner every time inclining towards the physical aspect? Am I an object of physical pleasure for him? So constantly when she has this feeling, why is this person wanting physical, wanting me for his physical pleasure? So here there is this delusion which comes, delusion, prostitute, she is a. So here disgust about femininity is also included. In the background, she has this disgust about femininity which runs in her mind, which has come from the thought process of the mother. So this is also adding up. So here the explanation for this rubric in the mind of Barbaris vulgaris. Delusion, tall, taller things, objects grow taller, synchronous with pulse. This is very, very important. Single remedy Barbaris is mentioned. So Barbaris feels that all these immoral things in society are increasing every second of time, and this situation is very, very terrifying for Barbaris personality. So delusion, terrifying. So the perception of this Barbaris personality is this. It is very interesting perception which comes from the genetic understanding, which I was able to understand through the study of this remedy. Again, another delusion. Delusion images, phantom sees education of a system of which sometimes assumes the form of a tree. A very long delusion. Again, I would like to repeat, delusion images phantoms sees education of a system of which sometimes assumes the form of a tree. So if we understand it plainly, so there is a delusion that this Barbaris personality sees, he imagines that there should be a system of education which should assume a form of a tree. So when everywhere he is seeing immorality, so in order to counterbalance this feeling, he wants to fantasize that there should be certain system of education in the society which should cover the whole society. In the form of tree means it should give the whole society the reflection of education, and then the people should again come back to the morals. So this is a single remedy Barbaris is mentioned. So now this is all about the perception of female Barbaris personality. For a male Barbaris personality, so here this male Barbaris is stuck in many roles in the life. So male Barbaris, they are in constant role play of father, husband, son, son-in-law, etc., etc. So life demands certain roles, and that is why Barbaris is also mentioned, I think, in delusion identity error, because his identity is always varying. So identity conflict for Barbaris is a variable identity. Sometimes he has to be like this, sometimes he has to be like that. So this is the identity conflict of Barbaris. So because of this constant change in the life, he feels that life is a burden. Delusion, life, burden. So all these things are the false perception which he is looking. So everywhere a delusion means there is a false perception. So this is the perception of this personality through which he is looking to the world. So because of all these changes, he feels that life is a burden, and he feels constantly harassed because of all these changes. Delusion, harassed he is. And sometimes he stuck in the middle. Sometimes there is a demand for him from this area. Again, that particular relationship demands his presence. So he is being pulled up in all directions. There is a delusion. Delusion pulled he is directions in all, because many a times he feels that he has to maintain relationship from this side, from that side, and from everywhere. So he is being pulled up in all the directions. So these are the delusions, beautiful delusions of Barbarus vulgaris. If these delusions, if you see in patients and then you prescribe a single dose of Barbarus vulgaris, and this will definitely give you miraculous result. And this is my understanding of how the Barbarus vulgaris personality is born. I hope you like it. Please share this video among the homeopathic fraternity for students to learn this new aspect, and this will help you in better prescription. Thank you all, my dear friends.